bedtime stories for adults, soothing sleep stories with guided meditation, dive into deep sleep hypnosis to prevent anxiety and panic attacks, let go of stress and relax. Written by Andy Benson, narrated by Adam Brazell. Introduction. Stress is something that we all carry within us. We have finances. We have relationships, romantic, personal, and platonic, that can weigh on us. We have careers that we have to manage. We have families, possibly. We have responsibilities that force us to act within the world, and those can be incredibly exhausting. We can find ourselves barely able to cope with ourselves in these times. In fact, roughly 33% of adults report that they struggle with sleep at any given point in time. They may find that they can't fall asleep. Others find that they can't stay asleep. No matter where you may fall on that spectrum, however, the consequences are real. You can't sleep and you feel awful. You feel like you can't successfully get through anything. You find yourself struggling with everything that you do, and that is not fair to you. It is incredibly unfair that you find yourself feeling entirely bogged down by your inability to sleep. And all day long, you will struggle to perform up to standard. You won't be able to help yourself or succeed at anything that you need to do. Sleep is essential to your day. It is imperative to your body and mind. You must be able to sleep at some point, and if you don't get it at night, your body will take it in other ways. Working heavy machinery when tired is dangerous. Driving while having not slept in the last 17 hours creates equivalent impairment to being legally drunk with a blood alcohol level of 0.05% due to the slowing responses that you will have. If you aren't careful, you can find yourself in a serious accident if you're not getting enough sleep to keep yourself well cared for. Beyond just causing impairment, however, not getting enough sleep is going to make other problems come to light as well. You are going to find that you struggle with being able to function in all aspects of your life. Of course, struggling will only exacerbate those feelings of stress that you have, and that will in turn lead to you getting even less sleep and a constant feedback loop of your own personal struggles. If you want to avoid this problem, you need sleep. Of course, that is easier said than done when you are tired and stressed out. Insomnia tends to repeat itself and make itself worse over time. It can cause you to seriously struggle by no fault of your own, but you can learn to fix the problem. This book is here to provide you with a handful of stories that you can enjoy that will help you to gently fall asleep. As you read through this book, you will be treated to 2 guided meditations and 7 different stories that are designed to help you. Those first 2 meditations are not the traditional bedtime story that you may be accustomed to. These stories are guided meditations. They are meant to help you fall asleep by redirecting your focus. The remaining 7 stories are there. If you have the first book, you know that there were 3 meditative techniques that were introduced. In this book, you will be introduced to another meditative technique that will be used. This time, we will make use of progressive relaxation to slowly but surely let go of your anxiety and depression or stress that may be holding you back from getting your sleep. You can find that sleep that you are looking for. You just have to learn how to achieve it, and this book will help you. You will also be focusing on the mindful concept of acceptance, of being in the moment and not resisting. Progressive relaxation starts first with a body scan. You will work your way throughout the entire body, bit by bit. You will look at each part of your body to understand what may hurt or where your tension or anxiety is manifesting. Then, with progressive relaxation, you will slowly release it, little by little. You will start with your head, feeling your scalp relax first, then your forehead, and your other body parts as well. Over time, you will eventually make your way all the way down to your toes and help yourself relax. This involves working over your body to leave yourself relaxed and calm so that you can achieve anything that you may want. Keep in mind that if you currently suffer from anxiety or depression, this book will not magically treat you. It will not make you suddenly undepressed or unanxious. This book is not the substitution for a doctor or anything else either. It is something that you can use to help yourself to alleviate symptoms of anxiety and depression by teaching you how you can relax your body on your own time. You will be empowered to take control of your own body so you can successfully achieve the sleep you have been missing. However, if you find that these techniques do not help you, you may want to consider seeing your doctor for a more thorough checkup to ensure that you are not suffering from something else that is causing the problem. Relaxation comes from within. If you want to be at peace with yourself, you have to be willing to accept yourself. You have to practice accepting the current moment without resistance. You must help yourself to stop trying to resist what you cannot control. You must sometimes be willing to accept that all there is for you to do is be at peace. Sometimes, all you can do is remind yourself that you must simply relax and be one with yourself. Sometimes, your anxiety is about things that you cannot fix, and that is what will keep you awake at night. The easiest fix for that is to let go. It is to release that fear and anxiety within yourself so you can do better. That is what these meditation stories are here to teach you. You will explore worlds and learn that sometimes you must just focus. Sometimes you must just go with the flow and see what happens. This is freeing. It will teach you that you don't have to waste your time worrying about things that you have no control over. Now, if you are ready to get started, a full night's sleep is within your reach. You just have to get started. If you are ready, find your way to your bed, get yourself comfortable, and let's get started. Good night. Story 1. Beachside Bonanza. Sophie completely forgot that she had agreed to go to the beach with all of her friends. And when her good friend Kara shows up, demanding that she goes along with them anyway, even on short notice, Sophie realizes she has no choice. She has to fulfill the beach day promise, and even if she doesn't want to at first, she knows that she'll have a great day doing nothing at all, and it will be worth every moment of it thanks to doing nothing at the beach. "What do you mean you forgot?" a young woman, perhaps 25, cried out in disbelief as she stared at Sophie, eyes wide. She had beautiful blue eyes, perfect blonde waves that cascaded down her shoulders, and a perfect fit body. She was the epitome of the beach babe as she sat there, staring at Sophie in shock as she waited for her best friend to explain herself. She was all ready to go herself, dressed in a bikini with a thin, lace cover-up and a wrap skirt around her waist. Her sunglasses were perched carefully above her face, and her full lips were in a full pout.
"Sophie, if we don't hurry up and leave, we won't get the best spots."
Sophie grinned sheepishly.
"I'm sorry, Kara, I forgot."
She looked around her house. She could probably be ready to go in about 15 minutes, but she still felt bad. Traffic could get quite bad on those Saturday morning drives out to the beach, especially when the weather was forecasted to be hot.
"I can hurry."
"You better." Kara frowned playfully at her friend before ushering her away with perfectly manicured hands. Kara was the kind of woman who had to be fashionable in all senses, but fashionably late. She was the kind of person that had to be perfectly punctual everywhere that they went. And if she wasn't 10 minutes early, she was late. Sophie, on the other hand. Now, Sophie was the queen of fashionably late. She was always running behind wherever she went and whenever she left. She was constantly finding herself battling against the clock. And unfortunately for her, she typically was the loser.
Off Sophie ran, tossing together as many of her beach items as she could into her beach bag, silently thanking the universe that she had felt compelled to shave the night prior. At least that was one thing she didn't have to worry about. Into the bag went her sunscreen, a beach towel, a change in clothes, her favorite book, and a water bottle, and she rushed into her room to change into her swimsuit. "I'm waiting!" She could hear Kara cry from downstairs, and she grinned. "I'm coming!" she cried back just as loudly. She picked up her bag and barreled back down the stairs as quickly as she could go. But Sophie, ever the ungraceful one, managed to slip near the bottom, crashing down onto her butt and sliding down the final three steps. "Oof!" she cried out, looking up at Kara. Her cheeks were tinged red with embarrassment, and her eyes watered a bit from the pain. "Shake it off, sweetie. We're going beach bumming." Kara extended her hand and pulled Sophie up with a smile before she squealed in excitement. "Let's get going. Everybody else will be there soon."
I know,
Sophie replied, rubbing her bottom with a sigh. It was just her luck to go to the beach with a bruised tailbone. She rushed out the door and headed toward the car, bag over her shoulder, phone and keys in hand, and ready to go. An hour later, and they were pulling up into the beautiful white sand of the beach. They were lucky to live in such a diverse area. The mountains were an hour away from one direction, and the beach was the other way, and on that day, she was thrilled to be there. The weather was projected to be 100 degrees all day long, and at the very least, being by the beach would make it bearable if they chose to get into the water. More than anything, however, Sophie was glad to be gathered up with all of her friends. It had been a while since they had all gotten together, and she was thrilled to have the opportunity to do so for the first time in a far too long.
"Oh, great!" Kara called out, raising one hand up as high as she could and waggling her fingers to a wave to someone with a grin. "Looks like Lucian, Sella, and Declan are already there. They got a good spot, too. Look, close enough to the snacks, but far enough away to where we're not going to be trampled. Good picking, guys!"
The last sentence came out as a squeal of delight as she tried to project her voice toward the other side of the beach. She grinned at everyone.
"Aren't we so lucky?"
"Incredible,"
Sophie agreed with a grin.
"Let's go."
As soon as their shoes touched the sand, they immediately came off. It was soft and so warm from the sun. Each step caused it to mold around their feet as they sank a little bit, but it was quite pleasant to walk atop. The sun wasn't overwhelmingly hot yet, and the cool ocean breeze brought the temperature just low enough to be comfortable. Before long, they were setting up next to their friends, complete with beach umbrellas, plenty of beach towels, a cooler of drinks, and plenty of excitement for the day. "Hey, Sophie," Declan called out with a grin. He was standing there with a grin on his face as he waved at her. He was topless, exposing his impeccably toned and tanned abs, wearing a pair of Hawaiian print swim trunks. Declan's warm, brown eyes met Sophie's gaze, and he was genuinely happy to see her as he passed her a cold drink from the cooler.
"So, how's the day going?"
"Smashing,"
Sophie replied with a grin, and Kara groaned in mock annoyance at the pun, lightly swatting at Sophie's arm.
"Sophie here had a bit of an accident this morning. No big deal," Kara chimed in. "Why don't you tell them about it?"
And suddenly, all eyes were on Sophie as she looked at her friends. They were eager to hear what she had to say, and she sighed.
"It's no big deal. I slid down the bottom of my stairs, that's all."
Lucian winced in response, flashing a sympathetic smile.
"Are you okay?"
"Yeah, fine," Sophie replied. "So, what's the plan for the day?"
"Just this," Declan replied, stretching out on his towel. "Lots of R&R out here while we soak up some waves."
"We could go play volleyball," chimed Sella.
"Or you could go play volleyball, and we'll cheer you on," Lucian replied, and everyone laughed.
It was great to be there, relaxing, and no one was quite ready to get out and get sweaty yet.
They would much rather spend the time just enjoying the moment of peace. Sella settled back down onto her towel.
What, Luce? Too afraid I'll wipe the floor with you?
Something like that, he replied through a sip of his drink. His eyes glowed with laughter as he looked at her. Lucian and Sella had been dating for some time at that point, and they were a great couple together. Lots of teasing, but Sophie could tell they genuinely cared for each other.
Well, I don't know about you guys, but I think I'm interested in some sunbathing, and then maybe burying Lucian in the deepest hole we can manage. Although, it'll be kind of hard to bury that level of ego.
Ooh, Sophie, I'm hurt, he replied, with a faux scandalized look on his face. Not as much as Sophie's butt, Declan tossed in, and they all laughed for a moment. It sure was great to be back together, Sophie noted. She was thrilled that they got this opportunity together. The group fell into a comfortable silence at that point. Sophie was sprawled across her towel, positioning it in the sun at the moment. She was lying, stomach down, simply watching the waves come in and out. Sometimes it was just fun to people watch while sitting about, and she was thrilled to have that chance. The ocean itself was shining a beautiful deep blue color, reflecting the sun off the ripples and waves as it gently lapped up on the shore, rhythmically creating that heartbeat of the song of the beach. The water went on endlessly into the horizon, meeting the deep blue sky along the way. There was not a cloud in the sky that day, just blue as far as the eye could see up until the sandy beach, covered in rainbow umbrellas, towels, and people wearing every color imaginable. Along with the sounds of waves, Sophie could hear the piercing cries of seagulls, and the squeals of laughter of both adults and children alike. The sound of music could be heard in the distance, and she could tell that the entire day was going to be great. A day at the beach was always a day of leisure, and even she never moved from that spot. She knew that she would be satisfied with herself and the entire situation. She knew that the day would be a total win if she could sit there just a little bit longer. As the sun warmed her back, she watched a group of children not too far off from where she was sitting. They were happily building a sandcastle where they stood, carefully scooping up the wet sand in their buckets that they had brought with them. The sand, when wet, was almost the color of brown sugar, she noted, and stuck together about as much as well. She watched them as they worked to pack it in and then carefully placed the lump of sand right into place. Their castle was quite intricate. It was clear they had done this a few times. It had four big pillars, connected with carefully hand-sculpted walls. All around the castle was a great big moat that they had filled with water, and they had even constructed a carefully built drawbridge with driftwood that they could push over and allow their small collection of action figures to cross at will. The castle was even decorated with all sorts of different items as well. There were seashell windows and a few sand dollars that were being used as decorations at the top as well, and a couple of seagull feathers as flags. All in all, it was quite creative. Soon, Sophie found her attention drifting to the nearby volleyball game. They were sitting somewhat near a net, likely thanks to Sella's preferences and affinity for the game. She noticed that Sella was over there too. Sella was petite with deep black hair, great curves, and bronze skin. She was fantastic at volleyball. She never ceased to remind everyone about her own experience playing in high school and college, and she continued to play at her local gym as much as she could as well. Sophie watched as Sella got a few great spikes in and wiped the floor with the opposing team, while Lucian was cheering her from his position as well. Sophie smiled as she heard him cheering for her. She was so glad to know that he liked her as much as he did. Lucian had always been the bachelor buddy, the one that they all bet would never get married or even settle into a serious relationship. Seeing him do so was a breath of fresh air. Her attention drifted again, back to the waves. There was a group of people playing in the waves. And further out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.